of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. It is my extreme pleasure to introduce Eric Holder, Attorney General of the United States. Thank you, Mr. Russell, for those kind words, and I want to thank you all. I mean, really, really thank you all for such a warm welcome. It is it's a privilege, and it is a real sincere pleasure to be with you, to be part of another important NAACP gathering, and to share the stage with so many good friends, dedicated partners, and indispensable leaders. I want to thank President Jealous, Chairman Brock, General Counsel Kim Keenan, and the NAACP's National Board of Directors for inviting me to join you here today. Now, I'm going to be very honest with you. It's nice to be outside of Washington, D.C. This feels like somebody just said, this feels like home. As you may know, I was born and raised in New York City, but Houston. New York's in the house. But Houston's feeling a little bit like home today. And it is also an honor for me to bring greetings from another brother you know, President Barack Obama. And also to bring greetings from my fellow members of the cabinet and from my colleagues across the United States Department of Justice. I'm also grateful for this chance to salute the essential work that you are doing here in the great state of Texas and all across our country to bring our nation together and to bring attention to the problems that we must solve, the wrongs that we must right, the divisions that we must heal, and the future that we must build. For more than a century, the NAACP leaders, members, and supporters have been defined and distinguished by your unyielding determination to do what you believe is right. And I want to tell you how much I appreciate and how much I am inspired by the example of strength that is this organization continues to provide for our nation and for me personally. This convention is focused on issues of real consequence, issues that directly affect people's lives and influence our nation's course. Now, I want to discuss some of the ways we must continue to build upon the social, political, economic, educational, and legal progress that this organization and generations of like-minded civil rights pioneers, activists, advocates, and champions have struggled and have sacrificed to bring about. Today's gathering presents an important opportunity to celebrate and to give thanks for the visionary leaders from W.E.B. Du Bois, and Ida B. Wells, to Charles Hamilton Houston, Walter White, Lloyd Wilkins, Dr. Martin Luther King, our dear friends, John Payton and Clarence Mitchell Jr., whose memory many of you gathered to honor yesterday, and whose critical work as the NAACP's chief advocate in Washington is being carried on today with a renewed spirit and dedication by my good friend, Hillary Shelton.